Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I commanded you. And surely I am with you to the very end of the age." To make, motivate, and equip disciples to reach their cities with the gospel. Tom Mahairas founded CitiVision in 1996, although its mission began in his heart long before that. Tom and his wife Vicky have served the Lord for over 30 years. They've used their experience to share Christ's love to their community and the world. The story begins in Greece, where Tom was born into a Greek Orthodox family. He immigrated to America at 7 years of age, and quickly got into trouble, having police record at 9 years old. In his teens, he got involved in the hippie movement, and his life was heading nowhere fast.
My life was going down the drain, as we say, in the gutter fast. I was sex, drugs, and rock and roll, as we used to say. And I was beginning to lose touch with reality. And I went to Central Park, and there were some hippies over here singing, "Where have all the flowers gone?" Over here. And I looked at that. And then there was some other people here, some Krishna people singing Hare Krishna. Something like that. And then there were some other people over here playing with the conga drums. They were Spanish, back and forth, smoking marijuana. I looked at them. There must have been 50, 60,000 just like this today, going all over the place in Central Park. All these people, and I looked up again, and I just felt like God was there, but I didn't know God.
In 1968, Tom came to know Christ as his Savior at Water Life Island. In 1974, after graduating from Bible school, he came back to the city he loved.
There was a divine call for me to come back into the Big Apple, New York City, to bring the gospel here. I'll never forget it. I was praying, and I was on my knees, and I got a phone call from New York. It was my friend Jim, who I had led to Christ the summer before. He said, the only thing I remember about that conversation is he said, "Come to New York and help me." And I hung the phone up and I said, oh, that was incredible. Was that you, God? I was asking God to show me. And in Luke 8, he showed me. He said, "Go into the deep. Go into the deep." And I realized that God wanted me to go into the deep water. And there's no deeper water with more fish than the island of Manhattan. And I thought, this is God. And then, on top of that, when I moved into Manhattan and down on 156th Street, and I opened the window up on the sixth floor, and I read a cross in 2-foot block lettering. I read right across the alleyway, "Where there is no vision, the people perish." I turn around as if to say, "Oh God, is that? I can't believe he's here." And you, the Lord, you just made it so clear that you were right there. And Vicky and I went up to the top of the Empire State Building. We looked around. We thought, what an incredible job it is. Back in 1974, we just wept, thinking that it's impossible. And the Spirit of God said to me, "You'll be able to reach them one by one." In 1974, we decided, hey, Uptown Manhattan, where I grew up in Washington Heights, is the place that God wants me to plant a church. And then from there, we bought the building on 401 West 205th Street, right here across the street. And we grew, and then we bought this building, the roller skating discotheque, and we continue to grow today. And of course, God allowed us to have a school here, the Manhattan Christian Academy, in 1977, and then the Transformation Life Center in 1982, and the Love Kitchen, and New York Gospel Outreach.
In 1995, God directed Tom to focus more on evangelism.
For years, I've been working in New York City as a pastor, but I've also been utilizing my evangelism gift in order to do that as a pastor. And having started a drug rehab, a homeless program, a school for inner city kids, God kept on working on my heart to the point where I needed to do direct evangelism in both churches, nationally and internationally. And when I was at the Promise Keepers national event in Atlanta, Georgia, with about 40,000 other pastors, that's when I made that decision to step out by faith and trust God to reach third world countries and especially the cities of the world, beginning with New York City.
From its birth in 1996, CitiVision has been able to holistically reach people in the inner city, as well as spread the good news of Christ throughout the United States and the world.
You know, all of these were just nets that I was throwing out for different schools of fish, and just doing some evangelism, loving people to Jesus Christ. And so here we are today, continuing with making, motivating, and equipping disciples to impact their city with the gospel.